Cardiogenic pulmonary edema is a certain type of pulmonary edema that is caused by increased pressures in the heart and is associated with congestive heart failure. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. Pulmonary edema is a condition in which excessive amounts of fluids collect in the alveoli of the lungs that results in dyspnea and impaired gas exchange. It results in shortness of breath because it prevents the body from being able to get adequate amounts of oxygen. As previously mentioned, cardiogenic pulmonary edema is a certain type that is associated with congestive heart failure. That is because it results from an inadequate left ventricle in the heart that struggles to pump blood as it should. This causes fluid to leak from the vessels that ultimately begins to accumulate in the lungs. Some of the signs and symptoms of cardiogenic pulmonary edema include hypoxemia, dyspnea, tachypnea, pink frothy secretions, orthopnea, diaphoresis, cyanosis, peripheral edema, jugular venous distension, and crackles on auscultation. Each of these signs and symptoms play a role in the diagnosis of cardiogenic pulmonary edema as well. With that said, the following diagnostic test would also be useful: a chest x-ray, ABG, complete blood count, electrocardiogram, echocardiogram, pulmonary function testing, hemodynamic monitoring, and cardiac enzyme analysis. The treatment for cardiogenic pulmonary edema may vary from patient to patient depending on the severity of their signs and symptoms. As a respiratory therapist, the first thing you will probably notice is severe hypoxemia, which can be treated with oxygen therapy. For example, the patient may require 100% oxygen immediately, which can be delivered with a non-rebreathing mask. Diuretic agents would be recommended to treat fluid overload. Preload reducers, afterload reducers, positive inotropic agents, and analgesic medications may be indicated as well. Additionally, non-invasive ventilation may be indicated to support the patient's breathing and help with oxygenation and ventilation. If BiPAP is administered and the patient continues to deteriorate, intubation and mechanical ventilation would be indicated. Again, for this video, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of this topic. We'll be breaking it down into much more detail in a separate video. Real quick, guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for educational and informational purposes only. And if you want to dive deeper and learn more about this topic, you can go to respiratorytherapyzone.com, where we have a ton of free study guides, practice questions, and other helpful resources. I'll drop links to everything you need right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.